हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12, वेलकम टू योर न्यूट्रिशन क्लास एंड दिस इज द वीडियो फॉर क्लास 12 डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम एंड दिस वीडियो इज पार्ट 3. सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट द ग्लैंड्स एंड द एलिमेंटरी कैनल विद द पिक्चर एंड डिस्कस अबाउट दैट. टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम. ओके, सो फंक्शंस ऑफ डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम. ओके, सो वेरी फर्स्ट, द फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज इंजेशन. सो दिस प्रोसीजर इन्वॉल्व टेकिंग फूड्स एंड लिक्विड्स बाय आवर माउथ. यू नो ऑफ द एलिमेंटरी कैनल द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज आवर माउथ बाय विच वी आर कंज्यूमिंग दिस फूड. So the procedure is also done by the ingestion procedure is done by the mouth. The second function of it is secretion. So the digestive system is responsible for the secretion of digestive enzymes and other products like bile salt while help in the process of digestion. Many of the digestive glands we have, we know that from these digestive glands actually proteolytic, lipolytic and amylolytic enzymes are secreted, and this is the function of this digestive system to secrete these enzymes to digest the food that we consume. Okay, the third point is mixing and propulsion. Okay, so what is it? Alternating contractions and relaxation of smooth muscles in the wall of GI tract mix food and secrete the proper them towards the anus. Okay, these capability of the GI tract to mix and move materials along the length is called the motility. Okay, the motility of the GI tract. Our GI tract, you know, it is a canal like structure. Okay, so when it is got contracted and relaxed, and in this procedure the enzymes are used to mix with the food and it also helps to move the foods downward. Okay, so it is the mixing and the propulsion of the food. The next function is digestion. What is the digestion? The main function of this system is used to digest food, that is break complex food molecules into simpler, smaller, easily absorbable particles that the body can utilize. So our body cannot utilize the food in which form we are consuming, right? Like if you consuming biryani, so the biryani in whole, a big chicken piece, cannot be actually taken by our body and cannot be actually absorbed by the cell, right? So it have to be decreased out. You have to be make the simpler form of it, and only then these parts can be absorbed by our cells. So this is the digestion procedure where the big foods, the complex food materials, are becoming the simpler form in the simpler form, and then it get digested. The fifth function, absorption. Okay, this system is also responsible for carry out the process by which the product of digestion get entry to the circulation. It is the next process of the digestion. Here the digested foods are being absorbed by the cells in the circulatory system. The next is defecation. So what is it? Waste indigestible substances, bacteria, cells from the lining of the GI tract and the digested materials that were not absorbed in their journey through the digestive tract or leave the body through the anus. It is the procedure of producing the feces. Okay, by the undigestible products and along with the bacteria are going to the rectum, and then we actually make the feces and it goes out from our body by the process of defecation. The next is protective functions. So what is it? Like the bacteria of the other microorganisms which contaminate food are killed in the gastrointestinal tract, especially by HCl in the stomach. When we will learn about the different parts of our body like the stomach in detail, we will get to know that the stomach is secreting the HCl. That is why the pH of the stomach, the pancreatic juice is, the gastric juice, the pH of the gastric juice is actually 0 to 5 to 1.2. Okay, it is very much acidic. Why? Because the HCl are used to produce on it. But when the food comes, the pH standards is actually increasing. It will be like 1.5 to 2. But still, it is very acidic. Why? Because for this high pH. So, pH and the acidity also have one more function. What is it? It used to help our body to keep protected from the harmful bacteria. When we are consuming some food, many bacteria and the viruses are mixing with it. Okay, are already mixed with it. When we consume it, it goes to our stomach, and then the HCl which is present in the stomach is used to split them up and destroy them. And in this way, the stomach, the digestive system part stomach is used to help us. It is the protective function of it. Okay, so then the structure of the digestive system. So our structure of the digestive system, we are going to learn about many parts, like the starting from the oral, starting from the mouth, and will end with the anus. There are many parts which are present in our digestive tract, and also there are many glands also present in our the digestive glands in our digestive system. So today in this video we learn about the functions of the digestive system, the very important functions. In the next video we will start with the digestive parts or digestive system parts. Okay, so here in this video, just recollecting everything, that the functions are ingestion, secretion, then the mixing and propulsion, then the digestion of the food materials, then the absorption of the food that is in simpler form, and next the defecation, the undigestible foods and foods which goes out from our body by the anus in the form of feces, and finally the protective functions of the digestive system. Okay, so in the next video we will talk about more. Until then, thank you.